Animo Azari.
Alexander III.
Starving at Full.
Fritz Helder.
I think we're doing the kind of house music that is not specifically any type of house, but great dance, kind of vocally driven sex beats.
I don't know. It's a mix of different varieties of house. There's so many different interpretations of where it came from and what it is now and all the different styles and the young and the old, and I think we try to fit in all the categories.
House is becoming like saying rap, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
It just, you know, there's grimy rap, there's Fresh Prince of Bel-Air rap, you know, there's Eminem, there's all kinds of different. So really it's such a broad term now that house.
Open ground.
I just like how American girls think it's cute when Canadians say house. They're like, house. They're like, say it again. House music. House music, say house. House.
That's right!
People in this band that know a lot more about house music and its history, and then if someone like Cedric, who had no idea, like no reference points whatsoever, but his voice is so indicative of that house sound. But that's what makes it cool, is that there's a variety of everything in there, from the extremely knowledgeable to the newbies.
I mean, we like to have depth of meaning when we're trying to make music. I'd say, you know, if you're making a beat or a sound or something, like, it's got to come from somewhere. It's coming from the pit of our stomachs. If we're having, you know, lyrics about, we're going to have a conversation about what are we going to talk about. You know, it's not just going to be what we're just going to throw out there. But having... Yeah.
There's a ritualism to it as well. You know, there's a hypnotic effect to loop-based music, you know. And that's...
That goes right back to, you know, tribal days, you know, dancing around a fire until you just let your body go into a trance. And we kind of take that style in the studio, and then it's been coming out live now. It's nice.
Most of what we're running is analog, you know? We've had clones built. We're using contemporary designers' renditions of older equipment, but most of it is analog. There's analog equipment still in there, and probably, I mean, there's more analog gear on stage than you know, your average Depeche Mode concert circa 1992, you know?
We're playing every night, so it's not that easy, but we're doing all right for, you know, using gear that's 30 years old or whatever. That it adds a dynamic to the sound, so.
People thought it wasn't possible, though, that gear's gonna break down. The gear's been this tight, you know?
Yes, please. The thing for Fritz and I, really, we like to have communication between ourselves and the crowd. Yeah. So picking up off on that energy is almost like second nature to us. It's like really a reflex, and yeah. it's pretty much a form of dialogue for us.
Yeah, and having that kind of stage persona is what keeps it exciting.
Yeah.
Because when you're in the studio recording, it's a lot more analytical, it's a lot more broken apart. So you to take, you know, months and months and put it into like one live session, you need to kind of create this person who can kind of like get all those moments together and deliver something that's fresh every night. That's the only way it can keep interesting and fresh for us, mm-hmm. and for the audience. It just kind of like becomes somebody else, someone bigger than, you know?
Then that serious person that, you know, that's sitting at the studio and
yeah,
focusing
when you're
on
studio,
that.
You're pretty serious. Like, you're not like serious, but you're trying to get something done. But on stage, it's just more about the celebration of
What's been done.
That it's done. Now we can just like regurgitate it out and be crazy.
Thank you.